Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to explain how to use expand and expand appearance in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. All right, I'm here in Adobe Illustrator and I'm just going to create new. We'll come up here to the top and choose print and then letter, and we'll create. Okay, I'm going to quickly explain the difference between these and why you might want to use these, and then I'll show you how I got to that point. So we'll actually be building the graphics that I'm going to paste in right now. Okay, so I've got a star with a stroke around the edge. It's just very simple. And then I've also got this expand word with a lot of different fills and strokes and effects that have been applied. And that is a different situation. So if we hit Command Y or Control Y on a PC right now, you can see the difference. If you watch the star, it's just a shape. But if you look at the expand, it just becomes simple text. If I click on the star and then go to Object Expand, and we go ahead and do the fill and the stroke and say OK, it will separate the fill and the stroke, and it'll expand the stroke to not be a stroke anymore. It'll be a fill, as you can see. Now, if I use my group selection tool to drag this away, it's now a separate piece from that star. A minute ago, they were connected. You couldn't separate them without going to Object Expand, of course. And our outline is now a shape. All right, let's look at expand. And I'm gonna drag out my appearance so you can see what's going on. I have a warp on this. That is this arc, and it's what's making it look like that. I have two fills and two strokes, and they've both been transformed. So when I go up to Object and choose Expand, it's not available. Expand only works with one stroke that you're wanting to expand to a shape. Expand Appearance is when you have an appearance with all of these different things. So let's go ahead and choose that. Now these are all grouped, so I'm going to ungroup them with Shift Command G or Shift Control G. And now you can see we've got that fill, we've got that outline, we've got another fill, and this outline. And it's changed all of our effects to be expanded, and now they're shapes too. So if we hit Command Y, it's no longer a straight line of text. It actually follows the shape that you saw before. Let's hit Command Y or Control Y to get back. Now let me undo all this. Now I've still expanded appearance on this, but let's come up to Object now and expand. And this will take all the strokes and turn them to fills. So we'll do that and we'll say okay. And now you can see everything is a shape. We do not have any strokes over here. So what we could do now is come to Pathfinder and just merge these. And then we can make some extra changes that we wouldn't be able to do if it were not expanded. So I'm going to hit P and minus and just delete these little points right here. Get rid of these. So we get an actual drop shadow that looks a little nicer. And I'll come in here with my group selection tool and delete these pieces and these down here. So both expand and expand appearance will allow us to edit parts of the design that we couldn't get to before, which is good, but we cannot turn them back into what they were before. So it's good to save a copy of the unexpanded version off to the side of the artboard. So I just pasted these in to show you what I mean by that. So before doing this, you'll want to make a copy off to the side that is unexpanded. I'm hitting Command Y and Control Y to show you the difference. So now I'm going to go into how to actually create this version of the graphic so that you could get to this point. And same with up here. This one's really simple though. Okay, so I'm going to select all and delete. All right, now the first thing I'm going to do is get my star shape. So I'll hit M on my keyboard and that'll bring me to my shapes. And then I can get down under here and get my star tool. I'll click and drag. And I'm going to hold Shift and Option, or Shift and Alt on a PC. So we now have a star. I'll hit D on my keyboard to get a white fill and a black outline. Let's change the fill to green so we can see it. So I used my color palette to do that. And if you don't have that up, all of these palettes are available under Window. So we can just go to Window and Color, which is right here. Okay, and let's increase the thickness of this stroke. I'm going to put it at about 40. That way you can really see what's going on with it. You can see that half of the stroke comes inside the blue line, which is what we drew, and then half comes outside. So if we reduce this, that's also the same. Half will be inside and half will be outside. Okay, so let's open up the stroke palette. And we can do a lot of different options here. We can round our corners here. We can align the stroke to the inside, although it gives us kind of a weird little shape in here. I usually leave this to the center. And then we can also align it to the outside. I'm going to go ahead and leave it centered for now. And I want to actually move the stroke away from this shape and have it be its own shape, kind of. So if we open our layers palette by hitting F7 or going to Window, Layers, and then clicking on this little caret, you can see we just have a path here. But if we come up here to Object, Expand, and we'll do the fill and stroke and say OK. You can see now that it's added a group to this. We've got a piece that has just the outline, and we've got another piece that has just the green star. So I'm going to get on my group selection tool, which is underneath your direct selection tool. And I'm just going to click this and move it. You can see that this is now a shape. It's not a stroke anymore. It looks like a stroke, but it's been expanded to a shape in and of itself. And we can move this one around separately too. The thing is, we don't have the option of changing this stroke anymore to be thicker or thinner or anything like that. So it's a really good idea to first make a copy off to the side. So let's undo and get back to this where we only have a path here. Instead of doing it that way, you'll first want to hold Alt or Option and just click and drag and pull a copy off to the side. And then you can go ahead and expand with Command E or Control E. That's the same as going to Object Expand. And then we'll get this dialog box. We'll say OK. And now we can move these apart and do whatever we want with them. Now they're still grouped, so they'll move together unless you're using the direct selection or the group selection. So to ungroup them, we'll just hit Shift Command G or Shift Control G on a PC. And now they'll move separately. So that's one use for expand. If you want a shape instead of a stroke, maybe you're making a cut file for a cutting machine and you want your outline to show up as an outline there, you'll need to expand it first. And we still have this one over here in case we want to reduce the size and make changes later. I'm going to pull this off to the side of the screen. Okay, now let's talk about expand appearance. Let's make some text. I'll hit T on my keyboard and click once. And then I'm just going to type out expand in all caps. I'll get on my selection tool, grab a corner and hold shift and make it quite a lot bigger. And then we'll come up here to the character and choose Montserrat. And I'll just choose extra bold. And now I want to get my appearance palette open. And I'm going to add some effects on this. Now, when you add effects to text, it's always a good idea to open up your character's palette and get rid of your fill. And then come up to your type and add a new fill up there. It's just a good idea to do this because there are things you cannot do with text if you leave the fill in the character's palette, like adding a gradient that actually shows up. It's just a good practice to get in the habit of doing that. Let's change our fill to kind of a yellowish green. I'm gonna click on my stroke in the appearance palette and add a black stroke to this. And I'm going to make it quite a lot bigger. And you'll notice it starts closing in like this. Let's reduce it a little bit. But because it lies exactly halfway on the fill and then halfway off the edge, it covers up some of our fill. And we don't want that. So I'm going to move the stroke below the fill, grabbing in the empty area over here and pulling it down below the fill like this. Now we can see the whole fill and only half of the 10-point outline. So we can increase this if we wanted to a little bit. I think 10 points is fine. We'll want to click in here with our text tool and just Option left arrow to bring that over. That's Alt and left arrow on a PC. We'll do the same over here so that all the letters are touching. Okay, now let's come up to Effect and choose Warp and Arc. Now, I like my text to be right about 23% on the bend. It's not too much, but it's obvious that it's being arced. So we'll say OK. And I want to show you what happens with your text if we look at it in preview mode. So hit Command Y or Control Y. It's just regular text. It's not arced like we see in the regular mode. hit Command Y or Control Y to get back. Okay, now I want to have kind of a drop shadow looking thing on here, so I'm going to copy both my fill and stroke. I'll click over here in the blank area and drag them onto the plus symbol. So now we have a green fill exactly behind this green fill and a black stroke exactly behind that one. Let's go ahead and change that fill to black. So I'm going to click this and just drag it onto the fill. Then I'll click on my stroke and I'll come up here to Effect, Distort and Transform, and Transform. I'm going to scale it horizontally by about 95%. We'll leave this one at 100, and then I also want a vertical move just to move it down 10 pixels. And we'll preview that. Okay, and that looks about like what I want. So we'll say okay. Now if we click this little drop-down caret, you can see the transform that I just added right here. I want to take this transform and apply it to the lower fill also, so we don't have these white areas. So I'm just going to click on this and make a copy. And then I'll just pull this up underneath this fill. So that got rid of them and gave us a more kind of normal look to this. Okay, now you'll notice we have four different pieces. We've got a fill on top, we've got a stroke under that, then we've got a transformed fill and a transformed stroke. And if you hit Command Y or Control Y, you'll see that this is just live text. You can type anything you want in here and it'll be just fine. That's the nice thing about using appearance. You can have everything applied to just one shape or one text path. I'm going to undo. There are a few more things I'd like to do to this. One is like get rid of this little white area here and here and here. I want to end up with one black shape and then a green shape on top of it. So to do that, I'll need to expand the appearance, and I'll show you what happens when we do it. First, I'm going to make a copy off to the side because we'll lose our text path and we'll eventually lose all the strokes and everything will become a fill. So I'm going to hold Alt or Option and drag a copy off to the side. Then I'll click on this one and we'll come up here to Object, and now we can expand appearance. Expand is no longer available. So I'm going to click this. Now we can use our group selection tool to click on these pieces and see what we have. We've got a green group here. We've got an outline shape here that is still an outline. It's not expanded all the way to a fill. We've got this other black shape that we made underneath it. And we've got that other outline that was underneath. So all four pieces are separated now. And if we hit Command Y now, you can see them here. Let's hit Command Y to get back, and I'm going to undo back to where we were. I want to be able to kind of join these pieces here, and we're not really to that point yet. So we'll need to expand again to get all of those strokes to be fills. So let's go to Object, Expand, and we'll do both the fill and the stroke. And now you can see that everything is expanded out. We don't have any strokes anymore and everything is a fill. So at this point, what I'm going to do, I'll get rid of my appearance. I'll come down here to the Pathfinder and then choose Divide. This is going to divide all those pieces into tiny separate pieces like this, which might seem a little counterintuitive, but let's undo that and get it back to where it was. And now I'm going to make the green one piece. So I'll hit Y on my keyboard, which will give me the magic wand tool, and I'll click, and that gives me all the green stuff. I'll go to my Pathfinder and unite that. And now I'm going to hide it to move it out of the way. That's Command 3 or Control 3 on a PC. Now we have all this black. I'm going to hit Y again and select all the black pieces, and we'll come down to the Pathfinder and unite those into one piece. I'm going to hide those with Command 3 or Control 3. Then I'm going to hit Command Y or Control Y to make sure there's nothing else that I don't want in here. So let's do that. I do see we have some shapes. I'll use my A tool, that is my direct selection tool, to highlight these. Now if you use your V tool, these are grouped with the things you hid. If you use this tool, it'll delete everything, not just these pieces. So be sure to use your A tool or your group selection underneath. We'll delete those. Now I'll hit Command Y or Control Y to get back. I'll show all with Option Command 3 or Alt Control 3 on a PC. So now we have two shapes. We've got the green and we've got the black. Now we can make this look a little bit better. I'm going to zoom in here. I'll hit P and then the minus to get to this tool, which is delete anchor point. And I'm going to come in here and just delete some of these anchor points I don't want. And here are a couple pieces that I don't think look very nice, so I'll just delete those too. So that is one way to use the expand tool. It's to get something like this to look more like this, and also to really simplify it. There are a couple other reasons that you might want to use the expand and expand appearance. This is a simpler form. It doesn't have any effects or anything like that on it right now. So if someone's using an old version of Illustrator that doesn't support these effects, you can give them this type of graphic. They'll be able to use it on their machine. Same with other alternate versions to Adobe products like Affinity or Corel. This way is kind of a what you see is what you get, whereas this way it's actually a little confusing. If you hit Command Y, your text doesn't really look like this. If you happen to upload stock vectors to sites like Shutterstock or Adobe Stock, you cannot have effects in them and they all have to be expanded before you submit. That's another reason that expand and expand appearance are important. It's kind of hard to explain when you need to use them, but I hope you understand it a little better now. All right, if you like the way I teach, I also have a few classes out on Skillshare, and I have a link in my description for 2 free weeks for new members, and if you use that, you'll be able to take all my classes for free. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.